Very good morning to all of you. Welcome to this online class on estimation of chlorophyll content. In this class, I am going to discuss about basics of chlorophyll, its functions and procedures of chlorophyll estimation by Arnon method, and how to calculate the amount of chlorophyll present in the unknown sample will be discussed in this class. Before going to know about the procedures of chlorophyll estimations, let us start with basics of chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is one of the important plant pigments which drives the photosynthetic process in plant systems. And chlorophylls are present in the green leaf tissue. In the leaf, it is present the chloroplast of this mesophyll cell. And in the chloroplast, these chlorophyll molecules are present in the thylakoid membranes. And these are the thylakoid membranes, and chlorophyll molecules are present in these thylakoid membranes. There are different types of chlorophyll molecules are present in the plants: chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, chlorophyll C. These higher plants, chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B are abundantly present. And these chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B are present in the chlorophyll molecules are consisting of two parts. One is called porphyrin heads and a hydrocarbon tail or phytol tails. And these porphyrin heads containing magnesium ion in the center and occupying four nitrogen atoms are there. And there is a tail that is hydrocarbon tail, or it is otherwise known as phytol. Structure of chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B are exactly similar, except in this methyl groups are present in chlorophyll A, whereas aldehyde groups are present in chlorophyll B. And this chlorophyll A and B are present in the photosystems, and it drives the photochemical reactions during the photosynthetic process. This is the absorbance curve of chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. It absorbs in the blue regions and in the red regions, and the maximum absorbance of light takes place at 663 nanometer and 645 nanometer in chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B respectively. Then the function of chlorophyll, this chemical reaction during the process of photosynthesis. When light energy fall on the chlorophyll molecules, then this chlorophyll molecule convert the light energy into the chemical potential energy such as NADPH and ATP, and that ATP and NADPH used in the carbon fixation reaction to produce the sugar, and later on it enter into the central metabolisms to produce fatty acids and amino acids. This chlorophyll content is directly related to the amount of photosynthesis, and several scientists using this chlorophyll as a biomarker for this vitality, plant vitality study. And different scientists use this chlorophyll as a biomarker for study of plant vitality under different environmental conditions. Chlorophyll estimation is routinely carried out in different laboratories by different methods. Different scientists are using different methods of chlorophyll estimations, and one of these most important method is the Arnon method of chlorophyll estimation. Tell us about chlorophyll estimation by Arnon method. And this is the original reference of Arnon in 1949. It was reported in Plant Physiology. For this method, these are the requirements. The acetone 80% is required for extraction of these chlorophyll molecules from the plant tissue. Then second is mortar and pestle is required for homogenization of plant tissue. Then third is cold centrifuge is required for the clarification of this extract. Spectrophotometer is required for taking the absorbency at 663 nanometer and 645 nanometers. Then the procedures. First of all, the fresh leaf tissue of 100 milligrams homogenized in ice cold of 10 ml of 80% acetone by a mortar and pestle and mixed well. Then the mixture is clarified by centrifugation at 5000 rpm for 5 minutes. Then supernatants are collected in a clean glass test tubes, After that, absorbency was recorded at 663 nanometers and 645 nanometers in a set spectrophotometers. And all operations are performed under dim green light at 0 to 4 degrees centigrade. Then the calculation of chlorophyll content. The concentration of chlorophyll can be calculated by using the Arnone equation. And the Arnone equation is chlorophyll A is equal to 12.7 absorbency 663 nanometer minus 2.69 absorbency at 645 nanometer. And similarly, chlorophyll B is equal to 22.9 into absorbency 645 nanometer minus 4.68 absorbency at 663 nanometers. And the total chlorophyll content will be calculated by sum of these chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B molecules. In this way, we can able to calculate the amount of chlorophyll present in the sample, and we can also compare the samples, the chlorophyll. Then the non-destructive method of chlorophyll estimations. Different scientists are using different instruments for measurement of chlorophyll content. One of these important instruments is the SPAR-502 chlorophyll meters. And in this SPAR-502 chlorophyll meter is a very handy instrument which can measure the chlorophyll content in the leaf when the leaf is attached in the plants. And it is a non-destructive way of measurement of chlorophyll. And it measures the chlorophyll content in the form of chlorophyll index. And that index is measured the intensity of light transmitted at 650 nanometer. This is the leaf cliff, and when it is attached to this leaf, then it measures the amount of chlorophyll present in the plant sample. This instrument is very handy, and it takes only few seconds for this measurement. That's why many number of sample can be measured within a short period of times. And now these instruments is very much essential for the screening of germplasms, for the field estimation of chlorophyll content. This is all about the chlorophyll estimation. Please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel, and thank you for watching my YouTube video. Thank you.